Assalamu alaikum. My name is Osama Rida.
Like
I'm a degree student, business. Just my question is about Salah. You've mentioned and give us knowledge about Zakah and how it benefit our society. So what about Salah? Why we should gather in the mosque? What is the benefit of it for the community and the society? Thank you.
Brother asked the question that in my lecture I gave the example of Zakat. What about Salah? What is the benefit of Salah? Why should we go to the mosque and have a congregation and gathering? Brother, I've given a full lecture on Salah, the programming towards righteousness. It's for about 1.5 hours. I don't intend doing that. You cannot cover all the points in one lecture. Salah is the second important, the second pillar of Islam. After Tawheed, believing in Allah, that there's no one except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala worthy of worship, and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam the messenger, the second is Salah. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the first deed that will be asked you on the day of judgment is about your Salah. And according to Imam al-Bahabi, not praying falls as the fourth major sin in Islam. Number one is shirk, second is murder, third is black magic, fourth is foregoing Salah. It is the fourth major sin in Islam. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad said, mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume 1 in the book of Salah, that if you pray in Jama'ah, you get 25 times, 27 times more sawab. So praying in Jama'ah is 25 to 27 times better congregation. And there are several hadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad. There are hadith of Prophet Muhammad, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume 1 in the book of Salah, that the Prophet said that people do not come to the mosque for the Jummah Salah. He felt like telling one of the Sahaba to lead the Salah so that he would go and burn the houses of those people who did not come for the Jummah Salah. There's another hadith in which the Prophet Muhammad said. So based on the scholars, praying Jummah Salah is fard. And if you do it for 3 times without reason, Allah blocks your heart. And according to Imam al-Dhahabi, it is the 66th major sin in Islam. Not praying persistently Jummah Salah in congregation is the 66th major sin. Imam al-Dhahabi also says sin number 65, one sin before that, that persistently not praying in the mosque, in the congregation, Salah with Jama'ah without a valid reason. There's another hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume 1, book of Salah. The Prophet said, the hypocrites did not come for the Fajr Salah or the Isha Salah. And if they knew the reward, they would come crawling. I felt like telling one of the Sahabas to lead the Salah so that I can go out and burn the homes of the men with them in it who did not come for the congregation Salah. So praying in Jama'ah, the 5 times Salah, according to very few scholars, it is Mustahab Sunnah. Majority scholar says it is Fard. Imam al-Dhahabi says in his book, in Qabair, it is the 65th major sin that if you do not pray 5 times Salah in the congregation in the mosque. So most of the scholars agree that you have to pray unless you have a valid reason, that if maybe you're traveling or if you're sick. Or normally at the time of the Sahabas, if a person did not come to the mosque to pray, he was either sick or he was a munafiq. That's what the Sahabas did. So praying compulsory in the Salah in congregation is a must. What are the various benefits? I can give a talk for 1 hour only on scientific benefits. Time doesn't permit me, but you can see my video cassette. You come closer to the Muslim Ummah. You get guidance from the Imam. Your khushu increases. The best time, the best peace of mind is the time of Salah. And the best part of Salah is the sujood. Allah mentioned sajda and sujood in the Quran 92 times. But if you know what khushu is, you will understand it. You can only enjoy the fruit if you have a taste of it. So if you know what benefit of Salah, one minor benefit I'll tell you. You know, people say, you know, the 10 richest men in the world, and list goes on, Mukesh Ambani number 10, and Warren Buffett, and number one goes to Bill Gates, now it is Jeff something, he's overtaken Bill Gates recently. Jeff someone, who's the owner of Amazon, he's overtaken Bill Gates, number one. And there was another post that says, number 10 Ambani, number 3 Bill Gates, number 2 Jeff. Number 1 is who? A Muslim who offers 2 rakat of Sunnah Salah before Fajr. Because the beloved Prophet Muhammad said that if you pray 2 rakat Sunnah before Fajr, it is more valuable than the earth and the wealth in it. So if you have a Muslim, you understand that, you will know the reward of that. It is a Sunnah Salah. Sunnah Mawqida. So imagine what would be the reward for the Fajr Salah. But how many Muslims realize that? Many do, but not all. If you know that, you know, once a businessman approached me, he's a billionaire. You know, but Zakir, I pray 4 times Salah, but I cannot get up for Fajr. So I told him that what if you have a meeting tomorrow, early in the morning, at 5:30, where if the deal clicks, you'll get $1 billion. He said, I will not sleep the full night. So I told him, you know, the Sunnah Salah of the Fajr is more valuable than the world and the wealth in it. Trillions and zillions of dollars. So if you have that iman and if you have that faith, then you will realize what important it is. That's what the Prophet said. If the munafiq knew what was the benefit of coming for the Isha Salah and Fajr Salah to the mosque, they would crawl coming to it. So unfortunately, most of us Muslims don't know the benefit. But alhamdulillah, I'm happy in Malaysia as compared to India. The percentage of Muslims praying in India is very small in the mosque. I would say less than 5%. But here, alhamdulillah, I'm happy that the percentage of Muslim men, Muslims praying in the mosque is multiple times more than India and Pakistan. But as a Muslim, the benefit you get, the sukoon, the serenity, the peace, it is much more than the wealth. So if you know what peace is, you will value it. If you don't know, you won't value it. So if a Muslim reads the Quran and the Hadith and understands what benefit it is, then you will care less for the material things. And you will come closer to the deen and you'll find the benefit. For more details, refer to my talk, Salah, the Programming Towards Righteousness. Hope that answers the question.